This is the story of Bantu, a little native boy whose home is in the jungles of Africa. A very exciting place for a boy to live. Just imagine, only a little way from your home there could be lurking a wild lion, a snorting rhinoceros, a scaly crocodile. But wait a minute, we're getting ahead of our story. There goes Bantu. Say, looks like he's running away from home. That's odd. Bantu has a good home and very nice parents. Uh-oh. Now what will Bantu do? There's no bridge, nor any boat. Besides, his mother has told him many times never to go near the big river. But something about today seems different. Bantu was busy trying to figure out what to do when he suddenly heard his name.
Hey, Bantu! What do you have in the pretty sack?
Yeah, what you got?
Oh, Gerry and Porky. Oh, you scared me while I was thinking here. Oh, well, this is just a little lunch. I might just go on a picnic.
Well, you can't go on a picnic all by yourself, Bantu. How would you like us for company?
No, I can't take you because it... Well, it ain't exactly a picnic. Well, if you must know, I'm running away from home. I never get to do what I want. My mommy's always finding things for me to do.
That's a wrong idea. That's wrong. Why, us animals don't act like that. No, sir.
No, he's right, Bantu. From the time animals are babies, it's just their nature to mind. And if they don't, it means trouble.
Well, I don't have a nature like that. Besides, what would you do if your mammy said no more fishing or hunting or playing because the missionary teacher's coming to have classes for us? I know all about them classes. You spend the whole day inside wearing hot clothes, and I'm not gonna do it.
Hey, that's wrong. Why, Gerry and I have seen the missionary, and he's come from far away, and he can tell you about some wonderful things. Wonderful.
No, you can't change my mind. No, sir. My mammy has got to learn her lesson.
And Bantu's friends couldn't change his mind. So off he went to find a narrower place in the river. He was in luck. There were some big rocks placed just right for him to step on.
Now, if I had just one more stepping stone, I could make it. Well, what do you know? There's a log floating right this way. I wonder if I can make it. Here it goes.
All of a sudden, the log came to life. What a surprise. Two red eyes blinked open. Two rows of sharp white teeth flashed. The big scaly body lunged out of the water. Mr. Crocodile almost got a free lunch, and not the one in the polka dot sack.
Oh, 1,000 pardons, my little friend. Well, for a moment, I thought you were an enemy. I didn't mean to frighten you. No, not at all. You know, I'm nothing more than an overgrown lizard. My mother always said I'm much too big for my age. It makes me sad when folks mistake me for one of those bad-tempered old crocodiles. I get so lonesome when no one plays with me. Say, would you like to ride on my back?
No, sir. You can't fool me with those crocodile tears. I'm not coming anywhere near you.
In a flash, the crocodile stopped pretending and snapped his jaws in fiery anger.
Very well, smart boy. You have to come back across sometime. And when you do, I'll be waiting for you.
Bantu knew he meant it, too. What to do? He really hadn't planned to go very far. He just wanted to scare his folks a little. Maybe running away wasn't such a good idea after all. He'd done the wrong thing, and now he knew it. But say, those thick hanging vines at the river's edge, maybe this idea would work. That was it. Just what he needed. A long vine to swing across the river or to the nearest rock. But as soon as Bantu caught hold of the vine, he was whipped into the air. What a mistake to make. What Bantu thought was a vine turned out to be the tail of a snake. And now the snake was headed down the branch, coming right at him. As Bantu edged slowly toward the end of the branch, it began to dip down, down, down over the river. Bantu was shaking with fear. He was caught right in the middle with trouble on both sides.
Well, well! You finally decided to drop in for lunch, eh? Come on now. Be my guest. Now drop feet first, please. I don't like to catch things in my mouth sideways.
Just when Bantu was about to give up all hope, he looked up to see his good friends, Gerry and Porky.
Oh, Gerry, help me, help me. Porky, do something, please save me. This branch is breaking, help!
But it was a lucky break for Bantu. The crocodile was so busy watching him that he didn't see the giraffe wade right out into the river. And just in the nick of time, Gerry's long neck scooped him up. The crocodile just couldn't believe what he saw as he watched Bantu slide down Gerry's long neck. It looked as though his chances for a good dinner were gone. Say, maybe he would have his nice dinner after all, because Bantu was caught. He was stuck fast in the thick, oozing mud bank. Bantu struggled with all his might to pull himself free. And the more he struggled, the closer the crocodile came.
Hurry, 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 Bantu. Go, 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 go. Hurry, 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 go.
The crocodile opened his mouth wide to clamp down on his tasty tidbit. And he got a mouthful. But not what he'd expected. Mr. Crocodile quickly lost all interest in Bantu and made a hasty but painful retreat.
Now, don't you fuss, Bantu. You're lucky you just hurt your foot. You see what happens to you when you don't mind your mother? Well, suppose we hadn't been around to help. Just suppose.
Oh, I know I'm wrong. But what am I going to do now?
Well, that's something we can't help you with. But there is someone who can, and that's the teacher. At least he can help your foot.
Yeah, yeah, maybe he can fix your foolishness, too. That is, if only you listen to him.
Well, here's the road that leads to your village. Say, be quiet a minute. You hear that? It's the noise of the animal the teacher rides. That's him. He's coming. Get off quick, Bantu. He's coming.
Bantu knew at once that this was the missionary who was coming to teach the village children. But he couldn't run anymore. Besides, could anything worse possibly happen to him?
Well, well, what do we have here? Are you waiting for a ride to the village? Say, let's take a look at that foot.
With strong, sure hands, the missionary cared for Bantu's foot, while Bantu told him almost everything that had happened. After all, big people don't believe in talking animals. Birds, maybe, but not animals. Bantu, it sounds as though you've had nothing but trouble since you disobeyed. I can fix your foot, but I can't fix your heart. But let me tell you about one who can fix your heart, and that's God. Look, Bantu, let me explain with this little book of colored pages. Now, this beautiful golden page reminds us of the place called heaven, where God is, where there's no trouble. There's a street made of gold, and everything is clean and bright and beautiful. You understand? Everything is perfect. There's no sin there, so there isn't any trouble in that wonderful place. God wants us to be with him, but we've done wrong because we're sinners. So how could anyone be able to go there?
I could try to be good.
How good do you think you would have to be, Bantu?
Oh, Buona, I'd have to be real, real, real good.
Do you think you could be that good, Bantu?
No. I do things wrong every day, and something always happens. Oh, like today when I ran away, I got into a lot of trouble.
You're right, son, you did. That's why this book also has a black page. It shows us that we're all sinners. God says in his book, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." But you know, Bantu, God loves us even when we're naughty and doing things he doesn't like. He wants us to be with him forever. Why, he loved us so much that he sent his son Jesus to take the punishment we deserve. That brings us to this red page, which reminds us of Jesus' blood that was shed for us when he died for you and me. He hadn't done anything wrong, not even one thing. And yet, he died in our place. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanseth us from all sin. Now let's turn to the white page. You see, it shows what happens to us when we believe that Jesus died for us and we ask him to come into our hearts. He does come in. He takes away our sins and makes us clean in God's sight. You see, Bantu, Jesus lives in our hearts, giving us a new life. Then we're ready to be with God in heaven forever.
But, Buona, how do we know?
Because God tells us in his book, the Bible. Let me read it to you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Do you believe this, Bantu? Do you believe he died for your sins?
Oh, yes, Buona. Yes, I do. I'm sorry for all the bad things I've done, and I do want Jesus to come into my heart, because I know now he can make me clean.
Bantu prayed and received Jesus into his heart. As he and the missionary teacher drove toward his village, Bantu was happy. He knew now, more than anything else, that he wanted to attend the Bible classes and learn more about Jesus.